We are here in Tanacon, the location of the Swiss Future Farm. The Swiss Future Farm is a demonstration farm for new technologies and aims to show farmers the benefits and added value of digitization. There are a lot of new things to see. In this video, I would like to present some highlights. Some of these ideas will be implemented in practice, some maybe not. But I'm sure you'll be fascinated by all these new ideas. You probably all know the problem that we have gaps in meadows. You can see uncovered areas here. When you're overseeding, the seed only germinates where the soil is uncovered. The solution works like this. A camera mounted on the front of the tractor takes the picture and detects the places where sowing is necessary. The seeds are then placed from the back of the tractor using a Krummenacher air seeder drill with 8 sowing pipes. Now sowing takes place only where the camera has detected a spot. A flap opens and closes and the seed is placed in the right place. At seed costs of around 300 Swiss francs per hectare, we can save around 200 francs if we only have to sow 20% of the seed. We are standing here in front of the hood of a special tractor. It doesn't run on diesel, but on electricity. Some people may think that electricity is not so important in agriculture, but together with an electrically powered forage mixer, for example, this can also be very interesting for agriculture, since it can use renewable energies to charge these batteries. Christian Wolf from the Solar Machinery Ring will explain how to charge these batteries. With photovoltaics, we can now produce electricity at production costs of less than 10 cents. This is cheaper for the farmer than buying the energy, with the restriction, of course, that electricity is only produced when the sun is shining. This is where the battery comes into play. We can store electricity temporarily in such a battery. Such an electric tractor is, of course, an ideal prerequisite to optimizing farm energy use in the long term. You are all familiar with the problem of paper chaos. This here will be the field book of tomorrow. We have GPS on the tractor, we know where we are. We have all the equipment parameters. Here, for example, for spreading liquid manure. We see how the tractor spreads the liquid manure. In the future, you won't have to write this down on paper. All the data can be collected directly on the tractor. This data will then be available to us for the various administrative tasks, e.g. for the FOAG. I think all tractors will be equipped with such terminals in the future. That is why this will now be put into practice very quickly. I'm convinced that this will make things much easier for farmers. We are standing here in front of the newly developed combine harvester, Ideal. What distinguishes this combine harvester from others is that it is packed full of electronics and provides the driver with a lot of support. You could even say that the automatic system takes over most of the driver's job. It's very difficult to adjust the individual units of a combine harvester so that we don't have so much broken grain or chaff in the wheat. The simulator offers the opportunity to demonstrate everything. In practice, drivers are often too overwhelmed to exploit the full potential of the machine. The driver can be supported, e.g. from a control center that can be anywhere on Earth. People at the control center can look into the cab via telemetric systems control and optimize the machine parameters.
Kann die Maschinenparameter kontrollieren und so den Einsatz der Maschine optimieren.
Agricultural technology has the reputation of becoming bigger and bigger. These are precision seed drills. Each of these robots sows a single row. What is interesting about them is certainly their low weight and that they therefore cause hardly any ground pressure. In addition, such a robot works day and night, makes no noise and is electrically operated. So it certainly has some advantages. However, it remains to be seen whether it will be able to compete with large tractors with seed drills, especially during time-critical work. We believe that this system also fits with small-scale farms in Switzerland and could be implemented into practice within 5 years.
In einem Zeitrahmen von 5 Jahren.
This is a special ear tag that this cow is wearing. It contains an acceleration sensor. The cow's swaying ears are used to measure whether she is eating, ruminating or resting. If there are any unusual data, e.g. if the cow does not eat for a long time, then perhaps she is ill, and then the farmer receives a warning. Every cow is a green dot. Yellow dots show that there are abnormalities with the animals. In this case, the animal has an acute decrease in ruminating. This cow, Eva, had acidiosis. The system sends a message to the farmer and he could then act accordingly. This is a weather station. It measures precipitation, radiation, temperature, humidity and wind speed. The special thing about this weather station is that it not only sends the data to the internet, but also receives commands from the internet. We can use it to manage irrigation. The advantage of the internet connection is that you can link weather forecasts. If it rains tomorrow, I have to water less today. If it's very hot tomorrow, I have to give more water today. So we can control the irrigation very flexibly. As you can see, the potential of digitization is considerable. The aim now is to implement useful innovations step by step so that everyone, including the farmer and the environment, can benefit from it. Thank you.